Done with this stupid Halloween game.
Lynsey, Silas is threatening to kill tonight, and we're no nearer to figuring out if it's Amy or Texas or Teresa or anyone.
Doug, what if he is just doing this to mess with my head?
Right now, there's a girl out there whose life is in your hands. Do you really want to take that risk?
Here's a ticket for you and Ryan.
Thank you.
It's pretty sweet. So how are you?
Oh, I knew what I was getting myself into when I married Carl. I was in love. Whatever that means.
Mom. It's Dad. Excuse me.
No, but just tell him I'm busy.
No, it's hard, but you're going to have to speak to him at some point.
Yeah, no, look, just not now, okay?
Whatever happens, I'm on your side, okay? Hey, Dad. I had a dream about you last night.
Did you now?
I was lying half asleep in bed, and you came into my room, naked. And then you slipped in under the covers.
See, I always knew I was the man of your dreams.
It was such a shame, though, that I had to wake up.
So, what are we going to do about that, then?
Halls of residence. 7 o'clock, room full. Don't be late. Hi, Scott. It's me. Yeah, I was wondering if we could hook up tonight.
No, it's too public. Silas wouldn't dare.
Come on, a costume party on Halloween? How can his ego resist?
Well, we'd warn Cheryl, and he's just not speaking to me, is she? Maybe we should warn the girls.
How? We've got no proof. Look, you try and get Cheryl to cancel, and I'll keep tabs on Silas, all right? It's got to be easier to follow one man than three girls.
Yeah, but what if she won't cancel?
But then you have to wear the costume he gave you tonight.
How is wearing some stupid Catwoman outfit going to help?
Lynsey, it's the game he's playing. Do you really want to risk not wearing it?
No, you're right. See you later. Hey.
And yourself?
Oh, so what, we can't even talk now, Chez?
Can you not see that I'm busy?
Like, what if you knew something bad was going to happen here tonight?
Like, whatever it is, Lynn's not interested, okay?
Please, Chez, I really think you should cancel.
Look, this little bloodbath is shaping up to be the biggest night of the year, okay? So if you don't mind, I've got things to do.
Well, girls normally get bigger tips as well, but just so you know, we will be splitting it 50-50, right?
Oh, I'll try my best, but maths never was my strong point.
Well, if you've got any questions, you just come and see me, okay?
See, I'm working behind the bar. What's the worst that could happen?
Oh, jeez! Doug, are you trying to kill me? Lindsay's right. Silas is the killer. This again.
Are you sleeping with her?
No, of course not.
But you're hoping to. Otherwise, why else would you be wasting my time?
Ethan, please just hear me out.
Doug,
She stole a necklace from a dead girl and planted it on a pensioner.
But what if Lynsey isn't mad and he's been taunting her, telling her how another girl's gonna die tonight?
Yeah, because that's what murderers do.
Yeah, well, and what if the world knew you'd been warned?
Are you threatening me?
Ethan, one of the girls we think he might kill is Teresa.
I can't wait till you see my outfit. It's gonna look amazing. I'm really excited. Yeah, I'm just gonna wait for Carmel, see if she can fit me in, and then I'll just go straight to the party, yeah? Okay, right. Liv, I'll see you later. Bye. Oh, I forgot to charge her. I'm so blonde. What do you want?
I do hope you haven't broken our rules. Because if I find out that you've been speaking to anyone, even Cheryl...
No, I haven't breathed the word to anyone, I promise. Silas, please stop this.
Oh, but we're nearly at the end now.
Please, I'm begging you.
Look around at all those girls, Lynsey.
How's it feel knowing one of them might be about to meet her end because you failed?
That's not fair.
That's the name of the game, I'm afraid.
This isn't a game.
Poor little Lynsey. People whispering behind your back.
You do know the world thinks you're mad, don't you?
Silas, what was that noise? Where are you?
Trick or treat!
I'm sorry, none of the McQueens are home right now.
Oh, don't worry, my dear. You'll do just fine.
Oh, someone will be with you shortly, love.
I'll take your time. I can wait.
In then.
Right, you okay then?
Yeah. Ages to know that Halloween's really big in America.
Is it?
Yeah. I wonder what Lee's doing.
Are you sure you're okay, Amy?
Yeah, having a really good time.
Well, if you think this is good, you ain't seen nothing yet.
Oh, stay. Thanks. Talos. Hey, Red, here you go. Courtesy of the masked man from yonder.
Well, for me, who is it?
You see, that's the thing about masked men. You just don't know.
Wait, you can't drink tea on the river.
I'm not just going to leap into bedroom after one cocktail. I might have written.
Ladies, please, do not fight over Thorough.
Well, how did you get him?
I scalped a couple of tickets off Texas.
I wanted to surprise you.
Can you get us some cash? I'll give you back.
Oh, check out the bloodsucker.
Vampires? Supposed to be sexual predators. Well, that fucked.
You're all right, smart mouth, just because you finally got lucky with the missus.
Ooh. You told, don't you?
Oh! Oh, Teresa, wait!
My, what big eyes you have.
Don't tell me you've come to push me over the edge.
About before. I'm sorry, yeah?
Yeah, don't worry about it. So, why did you make the bet?
Because I like you. And I thought if Scott Lewis was into you, then maybe you'd back off.
Do you want to go out with me?
No!
So, you don't want me, but no one else can have me.
Well, Scott's just a kid. You can do better than that anyway.
I don't get you, Mark. I mean, sometimes I think beneath that one-track mind of yours, there's a real human being struggling to get out.
Yeah, no, there is. There is because, if you think about it, that bet was like a compliment.
I'm leaving.
Oh, Texas, at least let me walk you home.
You know, seriously, Dodger, just drop dead.
Amy, can you get me some more eyeballs from the office? We ran out.
Ooh, if I had a pound for every time I heard that. Oh, sorry.
And I know you won't believe me, but as soon as Doug told me that you might be in danger.
What?
I wanted to make sure you were okay.
Ethan, he's here.
Not now, Lindsay.
Silas saw me speaking with you. You need to call the police now.
Look, let's find Doug and take you home. Lindsay!
You know we will, don't we?
I know.
And don't forget you're a lying, cheating scumbag.
Yeah. I'm aware of my mistakes. So things are strong between you and Will.
Yeah.
You don't sound so sure.
No, it's good. It's just ever since he started college and he's got new friends, I just feel a little bit fit.
You're not.
Will! Give me that.
Steady? Oh, nice costume. Where's your tickle?
I'm sorry. This is important. Can all the women here tonight please listen to me? There is a murderer out there among you.
Yeah, I'm the murderer.
Let her go, all
right? I just don't know who you are anymore.
Listen, where's Teresa? Who's there?
It's me.
Oh, you
Sorry, I was... Well, look, I told Dodger about us because I...
Because what?
Because I was worried that I was going to be terrible. And you wouldn't want to be with me anymore.
Really?
Do you still like him?
Who? Ethan.
Well, he's a policeman. I mean, it's pretty impressive.
Oh, aye. Apart from all the dead bodies around. Like you, idiot.
Really?
You've got nothing to be insecure about, I promise.
Because I thought I'd blown it.
Now walk me home. Because I hear there's wolves in these woods.
So you're okay now, then?
Yes, I think I am.
Good. Because there is an after party at the Roxy and Cheryl's given me two tickets.
Uh-oh.
So guess who needs a date?
Aw, thank you.